Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Stone Mountain 64. Some of you guys were doubtful of this very gameplay. Battlefield Squads, July 12th. I had very many of you doubting me, tweeting me, Ripstone! Ripstone! This team's gonna get destroyed! 2-0, baby. But it was not just me. This is just some gameplay from the live stream that I'll be pausing, kind of talking a little bit about with you guys in this stream. I thought we'd discuss it a little bit. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. This was actually available to play as well during EA Play, which was that weekend before E3. It ended on Tuesday. I've got some more vlog footage coming from both Battlefield Squads events plus EA Play. And a whole bunch of more stuff. It was a really, really fun event. Tons of celebrities. Some people now tweeting at me, hashtag StonedMountain64, which is also pretty funny. if you guys watched some of the stream. But it is... I haven't discussed my opinions on this thing yet. Dude, this game is gorgeous. The rain coming down and the details in this game... it's just insane. And this isn't like full quality gameplay you guys are watching either. This is actually in my video editor, just some of the raw footage that I had. There's a ton of other really good videos. I even uploaded one yesterday with this highest quality that I had footage for in some of the tank gameplay. The vehicles are beastly in this game. If you guys are familiar with my channel at all, I really got into Battlefield with the sniping and more particularly the air combat. The fact that you can work together so good in this game with the air combat is what really got me excited when I first got into the vehicle, to the biplanes, because it's not as vanilla as it is with standard jet gameplay in your Battlefield 4, right? It's not just you dogfighting, tailing somebody, and there's really not much you can do other than just spin in circles until you die. In this, you can actually get somebody in your backseat, or you can, and I don't know if it's going to keep it like this for the full release in the game, at least how it is in this pre-alpha. Some of you guys might have seen Pony Lion's footage where he did this to me. If you're in the standard, like, it was the default biplane that you could spawn into. It was a two-seater one. There's one-seater, two-seater, and a three-seater bomber. The two-seater, you could just get into the back and start mowing people down. So even if you're by yourself in it, that's what Pony Lion did. He jumped into the back seat, gunned me down. It was pretty bad, but also super impressive. Hops back into the driver's seat. So there's a little bit more you could do. The fighter plane, though, is the one-seater. Super agile. It only has that one primary gun. Absolutely destroyed. And that was really awesome, dude. But then there's the bomber. It went a little bit slower. We only got to see Conquest gameplay for this as well. This was the map that was featured. This is something else that was pretty cool as well, which I don't know if you guys have seen this yet. But there was this little indicator here on the Conquest points that'll show you how... it doesn't show you exactly how many people are on it, but it shows you the leverage difference between the two different teams. So, blue being your team, we have way more people on the objective than the enemy. Whereas if they had more people, it would be leaned over this side. And you can kind of get an idea of, you know, at least if it's even fully captured, you can still tell if an enemy is sitting on the objective. Let me know if you guys have any questions. I'm just going to talk some general action until I get some specifics, but definitely happy to answer any questions you guys have. It's going to be a slightly shorter stream every Thursday. I do these live streams, 6:30 p.m. Pacific, and look at Vardak and this damn behemoth airship. The losing team gets this behemoth spawned in. And you can actually drive it. No rails on this. That thing comes down wherever it comes down once it gets destroyed. And it is violent shaking. It's insane seeing that thing up there, dude. It's pretty insane. But the driver of it can bring it over specific objectives and just drop bombs. There's like three of them, I believe, and it just reloads over time. Did we see any other maps, Groove? And this was the only one that we saw. But it was a really cool one. Essentially, it was like, you know, the one side spawns on this like already battle-scarred land with trenches where you've been trying to defend it, and then the whole city is just like pristine, and you get to go in and destroy it. It's like, this is what I always love. Like, there's some areas that are already thrashed, and I was trying got the Jeep stuck back there in that part. But then you get to actually go in and destroy the buildings, and there is not 100% destruction like Bad Company 2, at least on this map. There's still a lot of walls up that you couldn't go, or buildings that you couldn't knock down, like, completely level it. Even the wind, like this windmill, you couldn't completely level it. But you could do a lot of destruction and a lot more, at least than I felt, in Battlefield 4. They just kept certain structures so you couldn't, you know, just completely be playing on a flat playing field. At least I tried throwing heavy tank grenades at it. That wasn't destroying it. Tanks weren't destroying it. Maybe if you had the bomber or the behemoth crash into it, that might have worked. Austin asked, is the gameplay slower or pretty even with Battlefield 4? I didn't play too much Conquest in Battlefield 4. I mean, obviously I did, but we didn't get too much gameplay on this either. I would say it felt a little bit slower. One of the things that really slowed it down was, like I talked about earlier, how you could actually see the indicator if enemies are still on the flag. So I felt myself staying at certain objectives longer to defend them, because it wasn't just a matter of capturing it and then somebody's just crouching or laying down in the corner, and as soon as you walk away, they already start capturing it, and you lose the objective. You knew somebody was there, so you're kind of going around trying to find the enemies. And this is actually pretty cool too. Let me back it up for a second. Not everything is usable, but this right here, I don't exactly know what it's called, but you can just hop onto this gun, and it's extremely good against tanks, which the tanks initially off the spawn, they'll come in this direction. You won't be here at this point by the point of the match, but if they start trying to come over into the town, just get on the turret. There was also a super good anti-air turret that was a little bit back closer to the base. It wasn't the full artillery, but another, like, these old school things that would just be props in other games are fully just hop on it and start shooting people down. It's really awesome. But overall, in terms of the speed, I'd say it felt like Battlefield, dude. It felt similar to the previous ones. That was the Zeppelin coming down there. I don't have the audio too loud on this, but look how the whole screen was shaking. I was like, holy God, dude. The Zeppelin just crashes down. That was a really cool experience, man. And look how chewed up these buildings are. Like, this was all pretty pristine starting in the match. And, like, there's even these roadblocks that are up on the road with, like, barbed wire. And if you try and walk through it, it'll actually damage you. But the tanks can just roll through it and just destroys it. Even the Jeeps are pretty powerful against it. And the Jeeps overall were actually pretty impressive. I didn't get any sniper gameplay in this, but I did use them. It was available to play at EA Play. It was also available, so even just you guys could have gone and checked it out. The last day, especially, if you were there, the last day especially, they had looks like a lot of open room. You could play FIFA as well at EA Play, which is where all this happened in LA. You could also play Titanfall 2, which I got some, didn't get some footage of, but I got a couple hours gameplay on, and I'll definitely talk more about that with you guys. I think this was the first game win. And some points I kind of stand still because I'm talking to Snoop and telling him, he was asking me what objectives to spawn at. We were trying to group up. We couldn't switch which squads we were in. So, like, I couldn't just spawn off him, which was a bit disappointing. But Look at the team that we had, guys. This is pretty insane. Drunks is one of like the pro players, plays like ESL, Battlefield competitively. Super beast. But he did really good on our team. Doom 49 also. Look at that, 27 kills, dude. He was using that light tank, which I uploaded a little bit of gameplay of just yesterday. The tanks were so strong. And I talked about that in my video yesterday, but they could repair themselves. What did you guys think of that? Like, when I first saw that, I was pretty blown away. Chat, what did you guys think of the self-repair for tanks and vehicles? If you've noticed that or even knew it. But you hold down the button, X, and it'll auto-repair. Let's see if I can pull up some gameplay here. I don't think I had it in game one. Some of this isn't in order also, so forgive that. I just thought, I have Battlefield 4 up in the background. Well, it's closed now because I got kicked for time, but I was going to hop into Battlefield 4, play some of that as well. Oh, here we go. Look at this shot. Hold on, let me zoom in here. Overlord says that it was pretty cool. Self-repair is awesome, Z-Sound says. Can you use the artillery guns? I didn't see the ability to use it. I went up to him. Look at that thing coming down, dude. It's just, and look at the rain. Like, it doesn't show it up super well on this screen, but that was the first thing when I saw it raining that I noticed was the details on the gun. It's just, it's so gorgeous, dude. It's really incredible, the immersion of this game and the graphic fidelity, the scale of the battle. Like, seeing this crashing down while you have these fighter jets overhead, tanks rolling up, you got all these old schools, just straight iron sights. It just felt real brutal. I've used that term a couple of times around, and it felt really good. We are losing objective butter. How are the automatic guns, semi-autos, bolt actions? Kevin S. asks. The automatics were my personal favorite. The SMGs in particular, I feel like most people were using that. The assault class, you had to do something about these tanks. They're just so powerful. With the assault class, you have the anti-tank grenades, and you had this bipod anti-tank, kind of like a rocket launcher, missile launcher. I don't know what it's actually called, but it's number 4 down here, you can see, where you have to be laying down prone to use the bipods and throw it out. And look at, Neebs had killed me earlier. This is me going up against him again, and I have the face cam footage. I was going back through this. Some of it's going to be part of the vlog that I'm going to be uploading. But I was like, yes! Come on, dude! I got it! And then I got killed. Retchie killed me so many times, Retchie. Damn it! You'll see. But I really liked the fully auto. Those SMGs were just so good. I tried using the medic, and the medic had, so each class had 3 different rifles that you could use, 6 total, but it was 3 actual rifles. Each of the different ones within it had different, like, variations of either, for example, for the medic, you can either do, there was a semi-auto option or a single fire option between all 3 of the different guns, and not, the last gun on there didn't have a semi-auto option. But those felt so, they felt very weak from close range and very weak from long range. So I didn't really find them to be that good. Like, I found myself in more close range situations where an SMG would be better. The support, I don't remember what it's actually called off the top of my head, but maybe it is support. Has the ammo he's dropping down, and of course has the light machine guns. Those were very powerful. A lot of recoil, difficult to use, but the key with that was prone, using the bipods. A lot of those had bipods. You could post up, and there's a different system for bipods, at least in pre-alpha, where I noticed when you lay down, same thing with this tank, anti-tank rocket launcher, whatever. the bipods just are automatic. When you're laying down, you're bipoded. Like, you can still turn around, turn as if you're not even bipoded. You know, like, you can just pick it up, move it around, and then when you set it down somewhere, you just start shooting and recoils decrease. Same thing if you just crouch up next to a window or something. It just, like, instant bipodded you. Like, it didn't have the animation where you put it down and, like, you couldn't move this because it's, like, on a swivel there. You could just drag it around kind of on the ground, more or less. And it was a huge improvement, especially for the light machine guns. When I was but I didn't really play too much of that. But the key with that was light machine. The thing is, though, it was just so more mobile with the SMGs that I liked those better. And the snipers, too. The snipers were really slow, like, you know, slow bullet speed, so trying to kill people really long range wasn't very good. Close range was very difficult, but I like the difficulty with the snipers. As Battlefield has difficult snipers, it's actual bullet drop that you have to account for, so I really like that. But I would say it was hard. I was talking to Study and Mugs TV as well. Both those guys are huge snipers. They both said that sniping was, at least they're the initial impression that they told me, maybe, I don't know, maybe I got it wrong, but it seemed like they thought it was really difficult compared to the previous ones because of the slower bullet speed. Oh, here's some of that tank gameplay, which you saw a little bit of, and I have some repairing of it. This is this was when I got Neebs back. This is what, and I got Jamie Fox and Amy Max as well. Got the psychological warfare of the teabagging in there. That's what led to the win right there, guys. Gotten their heads, gotten team captain's head. And he couldn't keep command of his team anymore after that. It doesn't, the game comes out in October, so we still got a while, but there's also been word of a beta to be expected. Battlefield 1 YOLO will be coming. Yes, dude. Cannot wait. Do you feel the Zeppelin is OP? Kevy the King asks. Great question. The Zeppelin, or the Behemoth, definitely had a lot of power to it. And you wanted to take this thing out quickly. The thing is, it's like, you, how do you convince your team to actually do that is the difficult part. But it definitely has a lot of power. The thing with the Behemoth, though, is it comes in for the losing team. So whichever team is at the disadvantage will get the Zeppelin spawned in to help assist them and to balance it out, which is another thing where I think it helps to slow down the... Oh, look at that shovel kill. Hold on. Where I think it helps to slow down the gameplay is that the losing team does get an assist. So you can see, here's the Behemoth. It's still at 75% health. This thing is not on rails. You just can fly around, go over the bases, drop bombs on it. It's a six-seater. You have a couple guys in machine guns on the sides of the turrets. Dude, that was a brutal kill. Which I actually have a little bit of footage of for you guys, because I did get it during the live stream. Again, this gameplay is from Battlefield Squads, if you guys didn't catch it. It was an epic live stream. So this is when I spawned into it. And the map, the fog on this map, guys, you have no idea how annoying it is. It's not even like in a bad way annoying, but just the gameplay mechanics. So this map, it'll rain, it'll be nice and clear and sunny, and then it'll be foggy. And you can't, like, look at, I can't see anything while I'm up here. So this is really like the ideal weather to defend against it. Of course, I die immediately when I get when I get in this thing, which was the disappointing part. But this is the side guns. You can see there's six seats. Me and Snoop were up here. The game as well. But one person's driving it. Looks like, I think Terry Crews might have been driving it here. And he's got like this giant wheel that he can be turning. And then you can kind of zoom in and drop bombs down. But the thing is, like, if you're in fog, it's super difficult to be effective with it. It's not the crazy hardest thing to take out. Even tanks, you can get a good angle and start sniping out some of the gunner seats. And then there's also one gunner seat on top to help defend against all the other air vehicles that are shooting at you, which definitely... Ha! Got your back, Reggie! Which there's... The air vehicles can do a lot of damage to it, as well as biplanes. overall, though, like, I didn't see... I never got killed by anybody that was on those side turrets. It was always the main driver dropping the bombs just over an objective and getting huge explosive kills for it. So I'd say it's pretty balanced for the most part. Are all the weapons balanced, Alex? They went for, you might have heard this terminology, rock, paper, scissors type of gameplay mechanic where each class is super good at what it's meant to do. If you're using an SMG and you try and do get some long range kills, then the accuracy just goes disgusting. From even long range, even if you do very slow fire, like one bullet at a time, you're not going to kill anybody from that far away. Snipers are going to be an advantage long range for sure. And actually, the bullet drop on it wasn't crazy. You know, it helped. It held its bullet drop pretty well, from what I could tell the snipers. It just was a bit slow to get there, it felt like. I don't know. This is when we were running through some objectives. And, dude, the points that you get for conquest, capturing the objectives, are insane. Watch how many points we get for this. Like, playing the objective part is incredible. So, just for getting points you're capturing. Plus, there was another mechanic which some of you guys may have noticed already. As you're shooting people, you earn points. It's no longer based on, at least for pre-alpha, how many... Oh, wait. Once you get the kill, you get your points for the assist. Instead, it's you get points for doing damage. So, you immediately know how much damage you did to somebody. If you... And look at that behemoth drop the bomb right on us there, man. See, that's what gets you, those bombs. So if you snipe somebody and hit him for 80, you don't have to wait for him to die in order to get points for it. You just immediately get your 80 points, which I really liked. Felt a little bit more rewarding for actually, like, just trying to shoot and get hits on people, even if you don't think they're going to end up dying. Because they might end up dying. This is the SMG. Got out SMG'd by the Automatico. This, I don't have gameplay of it here. But this one had, like, this clip that was a vertical clip, went up. It was a pretty cool one. Do I think the sniping's better than previous Battlefields, or worse? Or is it just different? Thoughts on sniping in this game? I've talked a bit about it. My overall opinion on it, though, was that... Loved it, dude. I like the difficulty with sniping. I don't think you're going to be able to get, like, all the way cross maps, of course. Dude, knowing you guys sending in your top plays, I would not be surprised if we get one day one. So this was also really interesting, and I don't know if this was talked about on the stream or you guys saw this, but how you actually spawn in, you can still spawn on your squads. If the behemoth is available, you can spawn on that. If there's seats available in vehicles, you can spawn on that. If there's an air vehicle going, you can spawn. It's all very similar to previous Battlefields. But in order to choose your vehicle, not everything's back at base. And you get some benefits for capturing the objective. So if you hold E, then you can get an extra tank. These are the tank icons. And it's not specific, like, oh, well, these are just the tanks that are spawned in. Let me just go run and jump into it. Instead, this is set up so... You can just you click on it, and I of course, let's see if I can find it. You click on it, and you can select which tank you want to spawn in as. Or if you click on the propeller one, you can choose which air vehicle, the bomber, the standard, I'll just call it assault one, or the fighter pilot, which is really good against other air vehicles. But I really like the spawning system and kind of that, like, zooming down onto the battlefield rather than just like, whoa, where the hell am I? It gives you a lot of perspective as to where you are when you spawn into it. So let's see if I can find something. So here's a bit of tank. This was in the light tank. You're just solo in this. And I think I have a repair. I repaired right here. If you guys are just tuning in, we're taking a look at some of the Battlefield 1 gameplay. This is from my Battlefield 1 squads gameplay. Ask me some questions in the chat. If you're watching this post, feel free to drop some questions. Let me know what you think about any of this. If you are just tuning in, give it a thumbs up. Greatly appreciated. If I'm missing your comments, feel free to sponsor the stream here on YouTube. I stream every Thursdays. Always greatly appreciated. Gives you a couple benefits. Also ask access to my Discord server. Chat with me. That's where I'm always online on the internet. Nice little benefit for you guys. Anyways, let's look at this tank gameplay. Repair. So this was, and maybe it's just because not everybody knew what they were exactly doing, but there was even one place, which is shortly after this, where I just get out of the tank. They think that it's going to end up, you know, being on fire and destroying itself. I don't know if it just wasn't part of the mechanics here, but it wasn't exploding on its own. And watch this. Get cheesed, mofo! Sorry, bro. This is good, too. Diablo saves me. Probably not, though, because he couldn't have done anything to my tank except wait for me to reload and then kill him. Only the assaults can really do anything to the tanks. Like, your standard bullets aren't... they're not going to do jack. Jasta, were there no British vehicles? I'm not sure. I think there were, because it's... Great Britain was part of this battle, I believe. I don't know, like, the backstory of all of the vehicles and all that quite yet. I didn't get any dynamite gameplay. We didn't see any horses either, so I can't confirm horse launching quite yet. Although, we can only pray. Battle pickups, Imagineers asks. I didn't see any. No, there was no battle pickups. At least not in this build of the game. The only thing that was around the maps that could help you out was, like, anti-air. There were some turrets that were actually pretty strong. Like, if a tank's rolling up on you and you get into one of those turrets, those can actually help take the tanks down. But, I mean, if you think about this setting in World War One, the tanks were, like, all-powerful, man. So, you really have that feeling in the tanks in this game, and I don't know if we should balance... that should be balanced out more. I personally think it makes sense for them to be super powerful. The instant, or not instant, but the self-repair inside of the tanks definitely feels like you have a really strong advantage. But, yeah, Vincent, I didn't get any plane footage from Battlefield squads. I didn't get any recorded from this live stream. But I did play some. I talked about that a bit earlier. What about the shotguns, Sandra asked? The shotguns were, there was only one shotgun that was available. I think there was two versions of it. I don't think I played with both of them, but they, I mean, performed exactly like shotguns would. They weren't strong at long range. Very powerful close range. You're just going to chew people apart. But it really competes with the SMGs. And this goes back to that rock, paper, scissors mechanic of what you expect to do good in different areas is what did good in those areas. Now, and this was really sick. This just... this was a really awesome shot. Not that I didn't get a kill with it or anything, but just like, so you could see, like, I shot this, nothing happened. Certain parts aren't, at least it didn't seem to be able to just blow it up and clear it out. Like, some of those are design mechanics that aren't going to go away. But the windmill in the center here, you take a shot, look at all the debris comes crashing down. You have a huge hole in the wall, exposing anybody that's inside. And it didn't just instantly kill him either. Although I did get some good kills, like, through blowing up walls and then taking out the guy that was hiding on the other side. I don't know if I got any gameplay of it recorded here. Were the anti-tank snipers good? There was anti-tank rounds on those snipers, which I believe you're referring to. One of the abilities of the sniper was these K rounds, which are like armor-piercing rounds. You shoot them one at a time, you gotta reload it. I was looking at that in some of the other gameplay, but they're not like, they weren't one-shotting things. You couldn't just shoot through and kill the driver of it. It did damage to whatever you were shooting at. And I didn't notice it. So this is that anti-tank rifle. I guess we can call it that. If you get a direct shot right on the tracks, though, you can disable the vehicle from moving. So that's always a really important thing to focus on. How many were on a team? 32 versus 32 is the max. At least what we saw from this. Who knows, there might be a bigger mode or something in the future, but from my understanding, it's 32 versus 32. This was the heavy tank. Beastly machine. Had a lot more health. Sat 6 people in it. Look at it. And it's kind of, I like the viewpoint of this as well, where you could see where they're all aiming and everything. It was really clear which seats were open. The part that wasn't clear was over here. You couldn't tell how many seats were available in it. So like when you're flying in the Behemoth, there wasn't really a good indicator to how many seats were even available. Like I think I was in that or some other vehicle at first. And I was like, oh, it's only a 2-seater. And then boom, somebody else just appeared in it. Like, what the hell is this? Or maybe if you're on the side, you can't tell too much. We have taken objective. What's your opinion on targets on the vehicles? Not sure what you're referring to there. Dominated Major Nelson. But see, there is a lot of, like, just run right through the wall. And I also noticed you can go, just climb right over the wall. Which is good. It's like, why you're a trained soldier and you can't get over a little 6-foot wall? Yeah, now you can. You can just jump over it pretty easily. Like, he'll do an animation and climb over it, from what I saw. I didn't see any commander either. Which, you know, could have been commanding my squad. So this, here we go. This was an example of spawning in on the tank. So, you'll see when I click it, I can either spawn into these four. But once I click it, now I can choose between the landship, heavy tank, or light tank. And you can also customize them. There wasn't any customizations available in the squad's gameplay or available at EA Play in general. But I can only assume there's going to be some good variations to unlock and use. Let's see. So you can choose between it and then spawn it. So you have a lot of variation you can use as well. And I didn't get any gameplay using it, but there's also this gas cloud that you can put down. And I'm not sure how this healing thing worked. I tried hitting it. I don't know if it healed your soldier or what, because you have the self-repair mechanic, which just you use by holding X to use. Oh, what's my opinion on the bayonet charge? Does MC asks. It's so sick. It's so sick. And I don't think I have any gameplay of it here for you, but while you're sprinting, you hit the melee button, and your guy just goes into a full, charges, and whichever, if you're coming in from behind him, stabs him. If you're coming in from the side, gets under his arm, skewers him, lifts him in the air, drops him on the ground, or even right up front gets him. I didn't see any countering mechanic, because I did get bayonet a couple times, even from the front. Oh, it was so sick. There's also a shovel that we could use and a hatchet. The shovel had like a kill animation. You smack them with across the face with a shovel. It's pretty brutal. And then, of course, the hatchet as well just goes straight into their shoulder. Like, if you're coming up front, hatchet right into the chest. Oh, man, it's brutal. But it's not the same animation every time you kill or assassinate somebody. You don't have to do the assassination thing. You can just kind of swing it. Now, when you spawn in, like you saw me using earlier, where you spawn into the either the air vehicles, the biplanes, or spawning straight into the tank, only if you're the person who creates it and becomes the driver, you get this repair tool. Likely, the repair tool is going to be available in the full version of the game. You don't have to get into the vehicle. You could just start hitting it with a hammer and the fire goes out because Battlefield. Or you can go inside. So this was what I was talking about earlier in the stream where this guy was shooting at me. The thing wasn't just destroying itself. You can see when I got into it, it was stable at 14 health. So I hopped in, repaired it. Now it's mobile again. You could kind of hear. Let's see if... it's not super loud right now, but it kind of extinguished the fire there. The tracks came back online and I could start moving again. So then I got out of the way, got to some cover. So that's the benefit of this like tank class and the pilot class. You get the repair tool. Maybe you can't get the repair tool any other way. You very well might not be able to, because they did want to separate out these things. Where you are very specialized for what you're meant to do. And this was a little bit glitchy. This was in my last video as well. Some people are saying, what was up with this? I actually killed Marshawn Lynch back in the vehicle. That blew up. And I thought that, because it was perfectly timed, I thought that I had killed Retchie. So I gave up on him. But there was like a little like glitched wall or something pre-alpha. So, you know, it is what it is. Overall, game was actually very stable, but that was an unfortunate death. Was the bayonet charge accurate, World? It was. And there's something really cool with the bayonet charges as well, was you didn't have to use it to kill somebody. You actually ran faster while doing a bayonet charge. So if somebody's like running obliviously in front of you, like he doesn't even know you're there, he might hear you yelling and just dodge out of the way, because you do have limited turn radius while you're in charge. But you run faster while you're charging. So if they're going, even in full sprint, you can catch up to them and just with your charge and stab them and get them on the ground. But you could also use it even more tactically and use it to get out of the way. So if somebody's shooting at you or a tank's coming in, you got to dodge quickly. You just got to get to cover. Use your sprint. Use that bayonet charge to get to cover. You can't cancel it, though, once you start to use it. So you kind of are left stranded if you do. What were the different types of planes, Zachary? I talked about that a bit earlier in the stream. And if you guys are just tuning in, I'll go back and try and set some time codes. Or maybe if somebody watches this back, put some time codes and you can click through and hear when I talk about all the different things in the game. Or about the game. If there's anything more specific I haven't talked about, though, let me know, guys. I'm still answering some questions here. Are the World War I weapons accurate, Thomas asks? The SMGs are not accurate at range, but like the snipers, wherever you scoped in at, it was pretty accurate to where it was going. Same thing with the LMGs. Those had a little bit bigger scopes on it. Those were going relatively where you put the indicator. This Lewis gun was pretty much the Syndicate gun from Battlefield Hardline. If you guys use that at all. I don't remember what the actual name of the gun was. I guess the Lewis gun. but that was pretty good. Again, bipods. Bipods were so key with the LMGs and those things. Best class? McGrath asks. I mean, if you still count it as a class, the tank class, by far. The best, dude. It was so good. It was so difficult to take out. After that, I give it to Assault, though. You're just able to do... The like, anti-tank rifle could even be used against players pretty effectively. The SMGs were really strong, full autos. The LMGs... There was some LMGs that were kind of more like SMGs. There was one that it had this, like, belt-fed... bullet clip, kind of. It was like a flat bar with bullets feeding through it. That one was a little bit more stable and kind of like an SMG, but I'd still rather have this guy. This was my favorite SMG. I don't remember the name of it off the top of my head, but you'll recognize it. There was only three of them. The Automatico was decent as well. Can you kill people with the repair hammer, Plump? You can. I didn't get any footage of it, but there's no way you couldn't. Are there any mortars in the game? Christian asks. Not in the beta. Or, I mean, the alpha. Pre-alpha. Who knows what's going to be in the beta. But we had very limited access to the... Like, each class, we didn't have any variations of items that we could use. And here's the turret that I was talking about. Look how limited your viewing is. So there's a big trade-off, but you can turn it as well. You can kind of rotate it around. Here's the crashed behemoth as well. Look how it just, like, I believe that. Yeah, yeah. Look how it just, like, takes up the battlefield. Like, it's just, it's a roadblock. I can't go just right through the road anymore. And it's completely leveled these buildings as well. So I guess the buildings are levelable. Completely destructible. It's just a matter of, you know, getting enough firepower behind it. Zach, we couldn't customize our characters at all, so there's no outfit changing during the stream. I'm not sure if it's going to be in the full version. Does bullet drop affect this game more than others? Pran, I used a bit of the snipers, and I didn't notice, like, an incredible amount of bullet drop. You know, I did do a lot of, I tried to use the snipers as much as I could, but there's definitely bullet drop. And, you know, it's not, like, the fastest bullet velocity, so there's a good amount. But I also didn't see anybody, like, all the way across on the other side of the map. It was always pretty reasonable. Like, some of them was probably, like, 100 meters out, and I was barely having to correct for it. And from what I noticed, there was a default 75-meter correction for it with, like, zeroing. Are airplanes effective towards the tank, Steven? Depending on which plane you're using. So this goes back to, like, if you're using the bombers, your primary in the bomb, so there's three different types of planes I was talking about. The primary for the bomber was just, you had these two big bombs that you could drop, or these four little bombs was your secondary ability. So if you're the pilot of those, it goes super slow. It's super heavy. But you can do powerhouse damage. And there's, like, this little, if you hit, I don't remember what it was, but it was like if you right-click or something, your scoping took you from flying into this, like, viewing reticle on the ground so you can kind of see where your bomb's going to drop. It didn't seem incredibly accurate. Partly, I assumed the technology at that time and whatever it was using just wasn't really that good. So I didn't end up killing a tank with it, but I didn't. That's because I didn't even come close to getting close to a tank. Every time you got into the air, if there was another fighter pilot up or a behemoth, they did massive damage to the bomber because it went so slow. But if you did not take out that bomber and just gave it free range to drop bombs on objectives, on tanks, then it did a lot of damage. Because I died from that. The good thing is with the bomber, it's a three-seater. You have two other turrets available. And this is where the squad's gameplay is effective. If you've got somebody who's flying with two turrets defending you, the turrets can spin 360 around. So they can defend in all different directions behind you, in front of you. It's powerful, dude. You can do a lot of work with that. Can the normal guns damage tanks? Mage asks. Not from what I saw, they could not. Potentially the LMGs could have, or the support class, but I don't think so. It was pretty much only the assault class, which is why these things were so damn powerful. Did I use the shovel? I did, Mustang, and I was, like, trying to hit the ground to see if I could, like, dig a crater or something, but it didn't work. The windows, you could just bash them in with the shovel or the hatchet, though, and then climb through it. And a really cool mechanic, I don't think I had any gameplay of it here, unfortunately, but these doors. So the doors are actually on hinges, right? And you can actually interact with them. So you can close the door if you want to hear for if somebody's going to be coming in through the doorway. Sound was really, really good in this game, man. Nice dirty little shot on Jamie Foxx there. But if this door was closed, all you need to do is hold sprint. And while you're sprinting, if the door is closed, you just shoulder charge it open and run straight through it. It looked like you sped up when you went through the doors. Like, I was just running. As soon as I found this out, I was just weaving through all the doors in the beginning of the match because you could just keep bashing the doors open while sprinting. You didn't have to interact with it, and it just felt really good doing that. I didn't see that with the windows, though. I did go up and, like, break the windows, and then I could climb through it. But that'd be awesome if you could, like, dolphin dive through it. That'd be sweet. There was nobody in particular that I really was looking to kill on the other team, like, besides Neebs, and I did successfully do that. But it was hard to even tell who was on my team while we were streaming as well. Like, we didn't have a really good communication system. I'm trying to see if I had the scoreboard up at any point here. I know I did it. Some points. I did use the land ship as well a little bit. I didn't have any gameplay of it here in particular. But the primary on the land ship was this, like, heavy machine gun. And on the sides, there was these two really heavy missile launchers. And that's where the power was, which I love. Like, you're giving the passengers more power. At least it felt to me you were giving them more power than the actual driver, which incentivizes you to actually work together. Liked it. I didn't notice, Sniper, I didn't notice if you could do digging a trench. I don't think you could. I tried hitting the ground. It didn't do anything. Are the Battlefield 1 maps bigger than Battlefield 4's Moneyless Tube asks? You can't really judge that so easily. I saw somebody else also asked if you can roadkill people. Not with this thing. This was too slow. At least not from what I noticed. But in terms of the Battlefield 1 maps bigger, too hard to tell. It's we had such a short, like, this was the only map, first of all. It was a really big map, though. Let's see. Could probably pull up the map overview here. So, I mean, this is the map, the full map. This is a behemoth. It's pretty damn huge. But it was a big map, man. And, like, it's so different. It's like this was that damaged area that was already, like, war torn, and this was the untouched village that we go in and start destroying. And it was really cool because this is a live updated thing. You could see the jets or the biplanes just flying overhead. Here's a bomber flying around, a fighter jet flying out, all live gameplay from the match, which was really, really cool. This is the behemoth, where it's actually going. And it was funny because it was a bit awkward how maneuverable the behemoth was. Like, it's not fast by any means, but you could just start backing it up and moving it. And maybe that's how it looked, but it just looked really funny from, like, the top down, seeing it move and turn around in weird angles. There's Vicstar and Diablo. Some good squad mates I had here. There is an announcer, and you can even hear her there. Let me see. I don't think I can hear. I can actually turn it up here. Hopefully this isn't too loud.
We have lost objective butter.
Some people were saying they didn't like the voice of the girl
We have
announcer.
lost objective Charlie.
But they also have, like, Apples, Butter, Charlie, Darth, Edward, or the objective names. Because back in the day, they didn't have the same phonetic language that we use now.
We are losing objective Edward.
We only saw this game mode. Let's see. I'm trying to read some more of your guys' questions.
We have
Keep them
lost
coming
objective.
in. I'll keep talking about some more of this. We have a little bit more time on the stream here. This is going to be a slightly shorter one, so I do hope you guys are enjoying. That dirty shovel kill, man. So good. Which tank did I prefer, Zell? I prefer the light tank the best. Just for the reason that it was so maneuverable and I like to depend on myself. Especially if, I don't have good communications with the team. Like, I didn't have somebody that I could talk to and call out where people are coming from. Damn it, Timio. He did pretty good. He's a beast. All right, what else we got? Anti-tank rifle. We talked good about that. Good bit. There was also no attachments for any of the guns that we could customize, so we couldn't change the scopes. I will say, though, that the sniper rifle that was Iron Sight was insanely good. I mean, like, it felt like standard medic rifles were not... I didn't like them, dude. It took like three shots to kill. Whereas if you just use the Iron Sight sniper rifle, it shot super fast. But it did like... It was a one-shot headshot. And you could like almost... I think you could one-shot chest shot. I'm not 100% sure. But it was really high power damage, dude. Hotwire with tanks? No, I don't know if... I don't doubt there's going to be hotwire mode. It wouldn't really make sense in this game. From Battlefield Hardline, hotwire. Is flying easier, Nicholas asks. What I will say is that third person was easier. And I saw... this is some of my feedback from it, was that third person... And I've even read other people's comments talking about this. The third person was so powerful. You're not going to see much gameplay from anybody, I would think, at least doing good, in first person. There was just no reason. Look how good the reticle is in third person. Even if you're using this, it wasn't like, okay, here's the box where your bullet could go. It's like, okay, this is a canister shot. This is your normal tank shot. So, like, you could get a pretty accurate shot. Just from being in third person, because it's the same reticle whether you're in first person or third person. And the same thing was true for the air vehicles. Like, normally I'm not that good in air vehicles on PC, but I was using some PC because that's what was available, right? Or that's what we were playing on. Dude, it was good. In third person, you could see where everything's going, and the flying was slowed down so much because those planes go so much slower. And you could kind of like cut the engine as well. You could really slow it down. There was no like speed indicators while you were in third person, so that was a bit difficult. You had to get it, kind of gauge it by feel. But that's kind of where some of the skill gap comes in with this game. Another thing that, you know, it's just kind of some minor things like being able to judge your speed. Another thing was with these tanks, when you shoot with the tank, and this is a really good pro tip as well. When you shoot, decreases your rounds, but it doesn't automatically reload. So you have 5 rounds between both your canister shot, shotgun shells, and your primary tank missiles. So if you switch between it, I believe that was how it worked. Let's see. So I had 5 here. I didn't see like how many each. Yeah, so I shoot it. Now I switch weapons. It looks like when I switched, it dropped one of the rounds, actually. Because now I'm down to 2 shots. 1 shot. But see, it's not reloading. And so you could just be driving around with 1 bullet left for the until you shoot your last shot. And now you're completely out of ammo and have to wait for all 5 of them to reload. Whereas if you're paying a little bit more attention, like you see me doing here, hit reload. And it'll start proactively reloading and getting you back to 5, which is really key. I wish I would have used the gas to show you guys, but it just... puts a big old fart cloud around you that kills people, and you got to throw your mask on. And you do have a mask for everybody that's in the lobby as well. It's just, it's like a default thing. Everybody's got it carried on them. You also can't like ADS, and you know, it's a little bit harder to see while you have your mask on and a couple things like that. The airship, the only footage I had from it, and I showed this a little bit earlier, and the only gun that I saw on it as well was this guy. So this was like it can do damage against ground units, but it didn't feel super effective the times that I did get to use it. In this case, I happened to die immediately. The real power with the Behemoth was the driver's seat, where you're able to drop bombs on the objective. And even in fog, you just go over by the objective. You can use the mini-map to see where people are if your teammates are tagging. Same tagging mechanic as in the past, but even better tagging mechanic because it shows you who the enemy's class are. So instead of just showing... At least... Yeah. So look, this is really cool. I don't know if you guys noticed this. So like friendlies, you can see here's Assault. This guy's in a Jeep. Here I'm shooting at White Boy. Ha-ha! Get wrecked! No, I don't even think I killed him here. Too elusive. You can see that he's Assault by the icon there. Here's an Assault. Here's an enemy tank in the background there. Oh, I got the assist. Nice work, squad. So, really good indicators for that. I know a lot of you guys like to play hardcore, so that might be good. And here's a clip of actually taking out the tank. So you can see, oh, here's my gas mask too that I was talking about. So you can't ADS while you're using this, at least from what I could tell or remember. And so I dropped out the second one, which gives me the vehicle destroyed. You get the tracks disabled bonus as well if you take the tracks out. Here's Snoop. Oh, I got some good... Stay tuned for the vlog that I'm going to be uploading this weekend, guys. It's pretty damn good. I'll have to double check that I can use all the footage that I got. But I'm excited. I'm really excited for it. I've still been going through and editing it. Were the gas masks used often, Perry? No, they were not. Because nobody was using the gas grenades. It was like nobody in the lobby was using them. So there's no point to put it on. Because it just hindered you when you had it on. There was other times when I was playing it at EA Play where people were throwing it down. But it wasn't like... It wasn't super good. And there was like incendiary grenades where you could drop fire. Frag grenades. There was even a light anti-tank grenade, if I remember correctly. That was pretty decent, but not too much of that. When is the open beta? I don't know, dude. Hopefully tomorrow. Nah, I don't know when it's coming out. I will be telling you guys once I do, though. So stay tuned to my Twitter. I'll definitely keep an eye out for that. And if you guys see any news, tweet it to me. I think we managed to touch on everything, though. The ground mechanics, some of the weaponry, some of the destruction in the game, air vehicles, ground vehicles, tanks. I don't think I talked too much about the Jeep, which you guys saw me use a little bit. I was driving Snoop around a little bit as well when we were capturing the objectives. I showed you that a little earlier. But they're fast, man. They're pretty good. And you can run people over in that. And you can't get shot at. Like, you can't just snipe the driver out. You know, you're not fully exposed when you're in it, like the Jeeps. And there's a lot of seats. It could sit 5 people in it. So it was pretty impressive. But when you're in the turret, I'm trying to see where that gameplay was. All right, here we go. When you're in the turret, like, you have this very small sliver of visibility. And I tried, like, seeing where that is to try and snipe him out. But I couldn't seem to find it. This is a pretty powerful gun, though. And I'm just... Anti-tank grenade. I tried to get out of there. But... Blimp or Zeppelin comments. I was calling it both, but I think it's called the Behemoth. It's the technical term that the game was using. I think. Support was decent, Arctic. I didn't use it too much. You know, people were using it to throw some extra ammo down, but for the most part, I didn't find myself ever needing more ammo. You could just pick up somebody's kit, or I seemed to always have plenty. Maybe because I was dying too often. Can the enemy go into your tank and destroy it, Joe? Not that I saw. I mean, I think the enemy can just get into your tank like any other game. I didn't hear or see anything different there, though. If you get out of it, I think other people can get into it. Like previous battlefields. Yeah, airship. Insane. Flying it. It's the best, dude. Do you take damage when jumping from a high altitude, Carlos? You do. And you still have a parachute. It didn't seem to auto-deploy, like I noticed some of them in Battlefield 4. You know, sometimes it auto-deploys, like if you spawn in on a beacon or stuff like that. It didn't seem to help you at all, and it seemed to be a little bit slower. It wasn't like instant, okay, you can just parachute 1 second before you hit the ground. It seemed like it was slower to deploy in this one. In terms of Levolution, Lonely Gray Wolfie asks, there is nothing like in particular on this map. I guess I'd consider the Zeppelin, the Behemoth coming down as the Levolution because it kind of changes the aspects. But that, and then there was like the changing of the weather system. That changes the whole level as you play. But there's no like floodgates changing the whole map mid-map. was kind of a consistent map throughout. The biggest change was when the fog rolled in, and then you want to start rolling with your SMGs and shotguns because snipers are at a huge disadvantage. You can't see anything far away. Air vehicles become... You can't even sometimes tell where the ground is. Like, you'll just go crashing to the ground. Are there any weapon sights? Not that we... I mean, so... I don't think I have any gameplay of it. There was some, like, crosshairs with a, that had a magnifier. There's a couple different scopes for, like, the LMG. But depending on which gun you chose, it had a default scope. I think all the ones I used were iron sights. Unfortunately. Ah, here was one. Oh, no, that was the prone. Are there any overpowered guns, Mad Bomber? Not in particular, not off the bat. The one that I liked the best was the Iron Sight Sniper Rifle, which I don't have any gameplay of here. But that thing was wrecking people. It just felt really, it felt really easy to use, and it shot so quickly. It was a very fast firing one. I think it only had like 5 rounds or something though. That one was so fun to use though. Even trying to get long range kills with it was fun. One-shot headshots. Like, I didn't get any super long-range kills, but you can even be up close and kind of just spam it a little bit if you really needed to. Like, look, the thing is, though, you get so many points for capturing the objective. Like, that was a total 600 points. And if you're a squad leader, like, I wasn't doing the best job as squad leader in this gameplay. I was kind of trying to do a lot of stuff at the same time. But if you mark the objective, you get like an, I think it was like an extra 100, 200 points for your team taking an objective that you mark as the squad leader or the squad position. And it's for the whole team gets the point. So it's really big on team and squad gameplay. I didn't get to take any of Snoop's gameplay or his like footage or anything like that. But I did play with him, and I'm going to have some of my live like commentary from the live stream in that vlog video that's going to be coming, so stay tuned for that. YOLO Battlefield 1 will be coming, dude. I gotta find like a good source for lingo from that time period, you know? Like, I know some of the objectives and things to call it, but I was planning on doing a shorter live stream, but we keep on going. I really hope you guys enjoyed me talking about this. I am going to be wrapping it up here. I'll just do another question or two. If you did enjoy, though, you liked me talking about this, I gave you as much information as I had from the stream, from the gameplay on Conquest on this map that was available at EA Play. Give it a thumbs up if you guys did enjoy. It's greatly appreciated. If you want to share this video out, help give some more of that information out there, get some more of the details going, I think it'd be awesome. Does the air affect, or the rain affect flying? It didn't in particular Endangered Cactus, but what did affect your flying was shooting the wings of the pilots, of the planes. If you get a sniper shot, one sniper shot on the wing... Even the general medic rifles were really strong, the single fire rifles. Even the SMGs, everything was really strong against the air vehicles. It's not going to one-shot them. It's not going to take them down completely. If you shoot the body even, it's not going to do a whole lot of damage to it. But if you just take the wing out, it becomes extremely frustrating for that pilot to deal with. Because while you're trying to fly straight, if you take that left wing out, then it's always going to be tilting to the left. So you always have to be countering it going to the right. You can't make as sharp a turns. It's harder to stay on your target. You can repair it, though, just by holding down the X button on PC, it was. You could repair your vehicle just like you could when you're on the ground. But while you're repairing, you can't control. You can't adjust your speed. You can't tilt or anything. So you want to be going straight. And it takes 4 or 5 seconds to repair, and so it's not, you know, it's not a perfect system. I don't even know if it repairs the completely, like, damaged, broken off wings. I assume it does. Because you can repair the tracks of your tank's tires.
We have lost objective Edward. We have lost objective Duff.
Did I like the HUD, Plumpchinkin asks? I did. I would have liked to make the minimap bigger. I liked that the map was actually integrated within the game. You didn't have to pull up the damn scoreboard like you do in Battlefield 4. I think I had an example of it at some point here. I was in the Jeep and I pulled it up. Yeah, here we go. Again, I apologize for some of the slightly lower quality. I am doing a... I'm just using my video editing software to just show this all live to you guys so we could talk and do whatever we want here. But, regardless, still bringing it to you as high as I can. So this is how, when you hit M, it pulls the map up like this, where you could get a good overview for the map. I really like the system, as you can see, as I'm sitting in the trench in a Jeep. This was a mistake. I was just trying to turn around and then... But see, you can just go right through the barbed wire, destroy it. So this was Snoop out here. He told me he spawned at A, so I spawned and then I was trying to pick him up and it was a mess, dude. It was a mess. Sniper one-shot in short distance and more. I was getting some one-shots. I think they were headshots or very high torso shots. And I don't have... Yeah. I don't have enough gameplay to test it out. Yeah, Snoop was causing some of the fog on the map when the fog rolled in. Some of you guys might have seen the live stream. It was a funny time. It was good times playing next to him, man. Any glitches, Edward? I mean, there was a couple, like, quirky walls and things you couldn't... Maybe some invisible walls and stuff. But overall, the game played very smooth for pre-alpha, and this was a pretty well-tuned map. I mean, the destruction all felt good. I mean, hit detection seemed good. At some points, I thought maybe I should have gotten a hit. It was also pretty much on LAN, so, you know, you didn't have to deal with, like, connection and issues and things like that. Oki Gaming says level cap said that one shot kills if within the right range. Could be. I mean, I did get a couple no scope, you know, when I was just spraying. I couldn't tell if it was a headshot or not. I don't remember if it was a headshot. Although I was getting so many of them that it felt like it probably wasn't a headshot. But yeah, guys, that's going to wrap it up. I was going to play some Battlefield 4, but we just got too caught up with the questions. I hope you enjoyed some of the gameplay, some of the commentary. Again, give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. Share out the stream to pass along some more of this information, because I did go relatively in-depth on some of this stuff, and I hope you enjoyed me sitting down and talking with you guys. That's it for this one, though. With the 2-0 victory, our team won the squads event against Neebs. We gave him the third one. No, they did good. But we took down... You guys were telling me we were going to lose because they had all the jack frags. You know, they had a good team over there. X-Factor. Oh, scary dude. Wrecked. Timio. Some good Battlefield players. Russian Badger. Like, but we had a great team. And it came together. So, anyways... Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon. This is Stellmount64, over and out. Also, stay tuned, and I'm going to be doing more gameplay and live streams and all that stuff soon. It's good. It's all good, dude.